My name is Loey Lane, and I'm so excited to tell you guys about my new podcast, Internet Urban Legends, with my BFF Snitchery.
We deep dive into the darkest corners of the internet to uncover whether some of the most notorious web myths are hoax or whether they're haunt. Internet Urban Legends, available exclusively on Spotify.
Hello, my loves. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new here. Hi, hello. My name is Loey. So today I'm going to give you a bit of a haunted house update slash just kind of chat with you. It's been a really long time since I have just turned on the camera and talked. I have gotten really into like the production side of my YouTube content in terms of being a lot more planned for my videos, not making videos unless I've written a script and I have all of the material that I need. And if I do something more casual, it's usually on stream and then I upload those videos, like my last one. At least I think it was my last one when you're watching this, where we just watched TikToks and stuff. But I think that there's probably something to be said for just like a stream of consciousness kind of chit chat. And I do want to talk about the haunting of my house, but I kind of also would like to just talk about my life. I don't know. Is this a therapy session? We'll see. There's just a lot going on that kind of ties into the haunted activity within the house. So I know a lot of you are here for the paranormal. You're here for the spooks. You're here for the scares. So let me fulfill from my last video until now, basically everything that's happened with my house ghost, Paul. If you haven't watched my first video on this particular house, you'll wanna check that out. I'll have it linked down below. I have a very large YouTube library filled with tons of paranormal stories, including ones from different places that I've lived. But this house is so special, and the haunting, the paranormal, the just energy here is so different from anything I've ever experienced. So it's just a different universe from everything else I've ever talked about. Imagine like the LoeyLane hauntings as a cinematic universe, and this is just one linear series that doesn't touch any of the other stories. A really big thing that was a theme in my last video was that my house ghost Paul does not like when my home is messy. So a few things, like I said, have happened since my last video. I kind of thought after talking about him so openly, making that video, everything like that, maybe things would get a lot more intense, but they really weren't. I didn't feel any differently. I still feel really at home in my house. I don't wake up in the middle of the night, like panicked, freaked out, like somebody's watching me, you know? It's a very like chill, nice energy in this home. So the first time that I noticed something actually was when it rained in LA, I think for the first time since I've lived here, or one of the first times since I've lived here at least. It was a really rainy day and the dogs were coming in and out from the backyard because they were going outside to potty and coming back in, and they were tracking in water and dirt and leaves and grass and all of that. And I went to go and shower. Like, everybody was already inside. I went to go and shower. The house is super long. Like, I'm sort of smack dab in the middle in the room that I always film in. My room is over here. The end of the house is over here. I guess that's very normal for a home. But it's just, like, a long house. Like, not a huge house. Just a long house. Like, so long, the Wi-Fi router, which is in the back of the house, doesn't reach my bedroom in the front, if that makes any sense. So I was in my room and I'm walking back over to the door to let the dogs out for the quadrillionth time that day. Sometimes you have a senior dog and he gotta go potty outside like 12 times a day. It happens. So I'm going out, I'm going to go let the dogs out again. And before I can even reach the back door, I see what looks like wet prints on the floor next to the dirt, the grass, the things I need to clean up. It looks as though somebody, like human footprints, walked from outside in the rain into the home, into the kitchen, and that's where the tracks stopped. Completely, completely stopped. When I first saw them, I thought, oh, I must have done that. I must have tracked water from the shower. And I went to go get a towel. As I was cleaning it, however, I realized that that did not make sense, because once again, I came from this side of the house all the way to the back door But the footsteps, the fresh, wet footsteps, were coming from the back door. So they could not have been my footsteps, you know? So once I realized, I was just like, oh no. Had a mini meltdown. Something you'll hear a lot is that I check my house when stuff like this happens. As much as I do believe in the paranormal, I believe my home is haunted. I believe that Paul, this house ghost that I have dubbed him as, I do think he's real, and I think he's the person haunting the house, and I blame a lot of things on him. I still want to be smart, so I went through the house, and the former tenants of this house actually left a gift. I don't know if I've ever talked about this before, but they called it the punishment stick of wisdom. It's a very long stick. And they left it for me, along with a cardboard cutout, weirdly, of David Hasselhoff. It's a long story. But I'm taking the punishment stick of wisdom, ready to knock some wisdom into an intruder, should there be one in my home. Of course, no one's there. So I was like, okay, well, hi, Paul. Sorry, Paul. I'll clean up the mess, Paul. And I just kind of like brushed it off. But it was something that actually happened, I think, right after I filmed that video in which I was telling you guys all about the haunting. So it was really crazy. I remember thinking, wow, I wish I could have fit that into the story time, and then just brushing it off. You know, if I had anything else to talk about, I'd include it in another video. Which is why we are here now, because there are certainly other things to discuss. Something I made really clear in my first haunted house video on this home is that the house is really, 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 really old, almost 100 years old, and like about to pass her 100th birthday old. And a lot of the appliances are really old. The dishwasher is old, the stoves are old, the toilets are old, and oh, the toilets have been giving me a rough time. I spend a lot of time in this room. This is my guest room, but it's also like my office. It's where I store like a lot of my costumes and cosplays and stuff. And I sleep in here sometimes if I don't feel like leaving this room or whatever. I hang out in here a lot. So I walked in one night. I had been sleeping in my other bedroom, and I walk in here. I don't remember why I came in, and it was literally in the middle of the night, like something had just woken me up. And I came in here and I heard like a glugging sound, and I walked into the room, and there was just water in the bathroom over here just spewing from the toilet. The entire bathroom was flooded. Partially the bedroom was flooded. Thank God there were no electronics on the floor, nothing like that. I immediately jumped into action. I'm like mopping things up. I know how to turn off the water to the toilet, so I did that. And I was just like, that is so weird. The toilet just started going crazy. Like, water spewing from like every source imaginable on this toilet. And it was just on the list of things that I needed to get fixed. So I call a repair person, they come, they fix the toilet, all is well. It's not paranormal, obviously. The toilet like spewing water is not like Moaning Myrtle from Harry Potter, but we're gonna get to why this is so weird. So the toilet did this thing. I got someone to repair it, but it was still leaking a bit. It wasn't like anything crazy. I just put a bucket under like the source of the leaking, and I kind of told anyone who came here, just don't use that bathroom for now. I'm gonna get another plumber out. Maybe I need to replace the toilet. It's an old house. We'll see. So when I went to my mom's wedding at the beginning of November, I had a friend of mine, Grace, who usually watches my house and my dogs and the small army of animals I have, I had her watch the house. And when I came home, I noticed that the toilet was like leaking worse than it had been before. And I was like, hey, did you by chance use this toilet? Because I think the leak got worse. I'll call a plumber in the morning, it'll be fine. I was just gonna ask if like something had changed. And she was like, no, I didn't, but it's weird you bring that up. Because apparently, while she was staying here, she slept in this bed and woke up in the middle of the night to the sound of someone flushing the toilet. And not just like the toilet flushing on its own. Like, she heard somebody push the metal like thing down, and she heard that toilet flush. And what's even weirder is while she was in here, she was like, that was weird, but she could obviously see the bathroom. She knew nobody was in there. She then heard somebody flush my toilet in my room while sleeping in this bed. So she was freaked out at that point, looked through the house. Of course, no one's here. you know, big spoiler. And I was just like, that is so weird. Maybe it's Paul checking the toilets. I don't really know. I thought that was kind of funny, the idea of him like walking through the house, like checking the toilets and stuff. Now I don't think it's so funny. I've been dealing with a lot of anxiety and stress recently, which I'll probably talk about later in this video, not related to the paranormal. And when the toilet was leaking worse, I was like, okay, I'll just take my wrench and maybe the water shut off isn't all the way there. I'll just shut it off. I'll call a plumber in the morning, and I'll get someone to come look at it. So I take my wrench. I try to shut off the water and water comes spewing from the toilet shutoff. What wound up happening is that the shutoff valve was so ancient, it was rusted, it did not work anymore, and so the water could not be shut off. So water is spewing. I grabbed a mixing bowl, I shoved it under the source of where the water is just spewing everywhere, and I'm like, what do I do? I call a Roto-Rooter. I'm like, I know it's 2:30 in the morning, I'm so sorry, I did not notice this leak until I was done playing Valorant for the night, like, what can I possibly do? And they said over the phone, you know, no one's really gonna be available until 8, so what you could do is go shut off your water, your main water line. And I was like, I have no idea where that is. That is simply not something I thought about when I got this house, that I needed to know things like that. I'm standing there, I'm panicking. I'm like, what do I do? Like, this bucket of water, this little mixing bowl of water is filling up every minute. Like, I can't sit there for 6 hours emptying it. And that's when I heard something knock on the window behind me. Mind you, I had been walking around the house trying to find the water shutoff valve for a bit. Supposedly it was like next to my water heater, or it is in a lot of cases. It wasn't in my house. I don't have like a basement or anything. And so I'm looking everywhere for this water shutoff thing. I can't find it. I hear this knock on my window. I go outside, and exactly where I heard the knock was where the water shut off was for the entire house. So I managed to shut off the water, of course. All was well until the next day when I had a plumber come out and he was like, yeah, like, I cannot believe like you did not have this happen before and you didn't have like a bigger flood. Like, so many parts of this toilet were just broken and bad, and like, you're gonna have to replace it pretty soon, pretty much. So everything was fine after that. But I thought it was so interesting that while I was gone, Grace said she heard like somebody checking the toilets and stuff. Then the leak happened. And then as I was sitting there in blind panic, somebody knocks on the window, and right where they knock on the window is where you can shut off the water. Like, where the water shut off thing, valve, whatever it is. It's like under a gate thing in my house. It's very weird. I'm telling you, Paul is a great house ghost. He scares me when he does things, but he always has a reason. I really think his main concern is keeping this house running. And I think that so much that the first night that I got back from my trip, I've said before, I don't think he likes when I leave very much, hence like him checking toilets and doing stuff like that while I'm gone. But the first night that I was back, I was on my computer. I was in my Discord server talking to my friends playing Valorant. And in this room, which was arguably the messiest room in the house, I had like left my suitcases out and, you know, there was clothes everywhere. There was so much to do in here. The vacuum cleaner, my Dyson vacuum cleaner, starts running in here. The problem with that, if you know a Dyson, is you have to hold down on the trigger in order, like, it's not something with an on-off switch. You have to hold it down. I hear it run. I stand up from the computer, it immediately stops. I come in here, just sitting right next to the bed where I probably left it. But I felt like it was just like Paul, like, okay, get to work. Like, really, really weird stuff. And again, I don't think like he's a particularly harmful or bad spirit. I actually am quite fond of Paul. I feel very safe and almost like I have a literal roommate. He makes me feel like okay when I'm by myself. I know that's probably very weird. Pretty much since my last video, I haven't communicated with him any further. I haven't had any crazy things happen. It's just that, like, I feel like he's watching out for my house, and as a result, also watching out for me. So that makes me feel nice. It doesn't make the things that he does any less creepy, to be fair, but it does give me, like, a sense of I don't feel so alone, even though I, you know, live on my own with my pets. So yeah, that's kind of the haunted house update. that's really all in that department. But when I sat down to film, I kind of just wanted to, like, I don't know, talk. So I think I'm just gonna do that. That, like, I don't know why it's so uncomfortable for me to just be like, hello, I'm not well. I'm not well. Hello, how are you? How are you? Not doing great. My mental health is potentially in the worst place I think it's ever been in my life. And so I wanted to kind of take a second and just say that I'm sorry for being MIA and for only really popping up when, like, I have to make a video. It's not really how I want to be. I still have a lot of love for YouTube. This is, like, my home, and this channel feels like my home and the place that I can come back to. And I feel like I haven't been very passionate about making videos because I've been so strict with myself with, you gotta plan everything out and everything has to be super scripted and, you know, you have to know exactly what you're gonna talk about. There's no wiggle room. I have been having a lot of issues relinquishing control of things, and I think that that's why I got so strict with how videos are being produced. I stopped using both of my editors, and it's not because either one of them were doing a bad job. It's not because, like, I couldn't pay them anymore. It's because I can't give up control of, like, anything in my life right now. And I don't know why. It's not that things feel out of control. It's just that, like, I have to do them myself. And I have no idea why. I've talked about it in therapy. I'm going to therapy 3 times a week right now. Like, that's where we're at right now. Did in fact think that I may have a trip to Grippy Sock Hospital, have a little Grippy Sock vacation for a bit, but I'm okay, I think. And I have such, like, a great life. Like, I'm really happy with my surroundings, with where I am, with living on my own, with my dating life, with my friends, with, like, everything, like, my finances, like, everything could not be, my family, everything could not be in a better place, really. And that's why I think it's even weirder to me that I'm so sad. I remember the night before my mom's wedding, I sat with her at the kitchen table and I had, like, a really big meltdown, which I felt terrible about the next day because I did it the night before her wedding. But I just told her how I feel like I don't enjoy anything anymore and how I feel like I can't turn off anymore, but I also am, like, so fully on that I'm exhausted. Like, all I can do is work and work and try to write for videos and make scripts and do this research, but it's never good enough for me. And so I don't put it out. And I know, like, the only way that I'm gonna get better is if I just try to let up on myself and try to put content out. I remember my Skinwalker TikTok video that I did. I don't know why I was being so hard on myself that day. The lighting wasn't great. I was traveling and I was like, nobody's gonna watch this. Everyone's gonna hate this. And it did great. And I remember, like, the next day thinking, like, I am so mean to myself that I sit there before I ever even upload and I'm like, nobody likes me. Nobody's gonna like me. Nobody's gonna watch this. Nobody cares. And then everyone's like, thanks for uploading something. So it's not just YouTube either. I'm having a hard time, like, just letting go of control of literally anything, to the point where I've told my family and everyone around me that I'm just staying in California for the holidays and I don't want to travel anymore this year if I can avoid it. I may have one more trip I have to do, but I'm just, like, not great. I don't know that in 28 years I've ever had the problem of I can't relax, I can't shut off, I can't turn my brain off, I can't sleep because I'm ready to wake up as soon as my head hits the pillow because I feel like there's so much to do, but I have nothing to show for it. Does that make sense? That makes me feel insane. And during that conversation with my mom, when I told her I don't enjoy anything anymore, you know, she asked if I had been going to therapy and stuff, and I said I have. I think I talked a little bit about this, but I've been developing some some, for lack of a better word, and I do apologize if I'm using this incorrectly, this is what I've been told by my therapist. So if I'm using the word tics incorrectly, I so apologize. But I've been developing some weird anxiety tics. There's this one that I do where it's hard to explain, but it's like a very high-pitched noise. Like I can't recreate it. And I like, it's almost like a shudder goes through my body. And I remember I had so much anxiety leading up to my mom's wedding that I was like, I'm going to do it at her wedding. And I was doing it 30 times a day because I couldn't stop thinking about it. It was stressing me out so much. And I had to like do this thing, like this weird shudder in my body and make this like noise. And so that's been stressing me out. I also started pulling out my hair, which I've talked about before, how I struggle with trick. And I have a nifty little bald spot right here because of it. So that's been fun. I'm not just trying to like sit here and complain. I guess it's just, I want to give like, I guess a bit of insight into like what's going on. Not that like you guys have ever like pressed for personal life information. I've gone through so many personal shifts in the last couple of years that I've never talked about, and you guys have always been very respectful. And I do appreciate that. But I also appreciate that I can share what I want to share and share like that I am not doing, I'm doing bad. I'm doing very badly. Little wins feel like really big wins to me right now. Cleaning my house feels like a huge win, but it's something I can't stop doing. I've gotten like obsessive with organization and cleaning to the point where I have like a daily routine so that my entire day is like spread out in front of me, and I consult a checklist every single day, which is very type A, not my personality, I think. The people around me know also that I'm not like doing well, and are obviously there for me and have helped me through it and stuff, and all of my friends have been so kind and so supportive through all of this. And I'm just trying to find like a sense of normalcy in what I feel like is just sort of a weird season in my life where I can't chill. I can't chill. But I'm also trying to be kinder to myself and give myself more grace and know that if there's anywhere I can go and just be myself and have fun and talk to a camera, talk to you guys. It doesn't feel like I'm talking to a camera. It feels like I'm just hanging out in my room with a friend. I know that I can always come here, and I think I forget that sometimes. And so I'm throwing this at the end of an otherwise totally normal paranormal story time in hopes that I will actually post it. Because if you're going through something similar, or if you're just like not good in any capacity, like if things are just sort of rough right now, I hope you know that you're not alone. And that it does get better and that we're gonna be okay. And this is just a weird, rocky season. But I just hope that if you're struggling, if your mental health is just on a hard decline like yours truly, and you're kind of experiencing new things you've never experienced before, that you know that it's okay and we're people and we take care of ourselves when we're physically sick. So it's okay to like be nice to ourselves when we're like not well. We don't ask ourselves, oh, why did I get this cold? Why is my body so weak? Like, why did my immune system let me get this evil little nasty bug? I think for me, it's helpful to remember that I also wouldn't say that about like my mental illness. Like, why am I like this? Why? What is wrong with me that I don't enjoy anything, but I have the best life and I'm literally tearing my hair out of my head and like stressing myself out over making a weird sound at my mom's wedding to the point that I can't sleep for days. Like it sounds ridiculous that I would be mean to myself over that or like just hard on myself, but here we are. I think that's all I really had to say, best friends. I think I'm gonna go make myself a PB&J. I'm not gonna do my subscriber shout out for the end of this video. I need to get back on my members exclusive videos. And also it feels kind of weird coming off of like a serious chat like that to be like, thank you so much. And if you want to hit the join button, you can. But listen, I do appreciate every single one of you out there. And I appreciate those of you who listened, both for the paranormal story and for the little chat after. So if you did enjoy the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. You get it, you get it. I love you guys so much. Thanks for being here as always. I will try to be back and take my normal pills sometime soon. But until then, I love you, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.